Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, Mr. Burnside.
Glad to see you all looking so bright and happy. All those who haven't had breakfast will have to wait now until they have lunch. How many absent, Mr. Stewart? Only one? Ah, Cleopatra Cassidy again. Wonder what the excuse will be this time. I suppose she's had a fire in her house and she's waiting for the engines to arrive. Ah, here she is now. Good morning, Cleopatra. What's the trouble this time? Subway tied up again? No? Well, what's happened? You're 15 minutes late and everybody here is waiting for you. What's that?
Had some trouble with my motor again.
Well, you'll have some trouble with your salary again at the end of the week. Now come along, everybody, and let's get this rehearsal started. Stop talking, girls. This isn't a suffragette meeting. We'll begin with a chin-chin number.
Oh, I hate that chin-chin.
Silence! I said chin-chin, not talk-talk. Why don't you pay attention, Mabel? Where do you think you are, in Central Park? Watch your step now, watch your step. Agnes McCarty, if Mr. Dillingham puts you in the next show, I won't rehearse it. Now stop, look, and listen, all of you. The singing last night was awful. You must pay more attention to the musical director. All except you, Agnes. You're paying too much attention to him. If you don't stop it, I'll call his wife's attention to you. Now, girls, you must be more careful during the performance. The show is simply going to pieces. And why? I ask you why. Because of the way you're going through it. And you must stop talking off the stage. Poor Mr. Stewart has lost his voice, asking you to keep quiet. You needn't cry, Miss Mineola. He hasn't lost it for good. You'll hear from him before the day is over, so don't worry. Now, girls, for the love of the Hippodrome, do be more careful in these musical numbers. And sing. For goodness sake, sing. If you're saving your voices for grand opera, take my advice and don't. Another thing, you must stop this solo work in the ballet. You've been taught to do the same steps in unison, and that is the effect. Everybody doing the same step at the same time. So remember that. You particularly, Miss Diamond, you can put that solo stuff you were doing last night in the March of the States in the new show that they're going to do at the stadium next summer, called A Piece of Cheese. That'll make it a strong show. Now cheer up and get together, all of you. Remember that you're just as important in the Hippodrome show as the principal, even if they don't think so. Let your motto be Hip Hip Hooray for the Hippodrome and CBD. Here endeth Lecture 666. Goodbye, girls. I'm through. Now, Mr. Hubble, it's up to you. You'd better let them rehearse the Ladder of Roses and see if they can do it better than they did last night.